I'm walking along the so-called Knox Trail from Fort Ticonderoga to Boston to raise awareness of the markers that were placed along the trail by the New York and Massachusetts state governments in the 20s. I can't fathom what Knox and his men went through in the winter of 1775 and 1776 with the sleds and the oxen and the cannons. And we're not trying to replicate that, obviously, or say that we are worthy of, you know, their kind of noble stature at all. But we do want to raise awareness of what they did and of the markers that were placed honoring them. You know, we've walked this trail trying to learn more and get more of an insight about Knox. Here's the interesting thing. Near all these Knox markers, there's other markers of historical significance from either the French and Indian Wars or predating that and other aspects of the Revolution. So it's like the more you travel, the deeper you get, and there's layers. So near a Knox marker, there'll be a George Washington marker, and near that, there'll be some other kind of site or marker of historical significance, and there's just layers of it. And that's what I kind of like about American history and history in general. It's not just this linear story. There's overlap. There's layers. You really have to, sometimes you stumble upon really interesting things purely by accident. I think it's important. And actually this trip has proved this. We've been in so many towns where there's actual markers and the people don't know about the markers. They don't know about Knox. And it really reinforces the fact that, you know, if people don't do ridiculous things like this sometimes, history might get lost. I don't profess to know everything about Knox or the area. That's why I'm doing this. I want to learn more about Knox and the road that he took.